Hey there everyone, this is Cypher, going back to my playthrough of Etrian Odyssey 3. In the previous part, we had gotten started on my favorite two floors of the game, the 15th and 16th floor, and in this part we are going to continue doing the 15th and 16th floor. I don't think there's much plot left for the 15th and 16th floor other than the end of it, so it won't be too long, it won't take too long to get there. I'm going to see you back in Ivan Ghazi Powder Room, and we'll continue from there. Wait. Wow, I am so stupid, I completely forgot that I actually did not go to the Deep City to report that in. I need to go do that. And while I'm at it, I'm gonna go back there to sell the stuff. So, Cypher the Mysterious Stuff. You've returned! Then you must know the truth of those from Armor Road. They claim they will vanquish the evil. And even now advance toward the Abyssal Shrine. There is more you do not know. Olympia has witnessed something you should be aware of. A man called Kojira of Armroad was searching for a flower that blossoms in the shrine. If you went the Armroad route, this is what you were doing the entire time you were there. Its name is the Amaranthos, and to you, it is a poisonous blossom. To them, it is the healing grace of the city. But to the deep ones, it is a nourishment and sustenance. This lends credence to my suspicion, and I have absolutely no idea what credence means. This is going to be the first long word in such a long time, and now I just need to find a pen that works. Screw it, I'll use a Sharpie. So, okay, so we've got new word credence. That's weird. I'm sure he might have said it before, but I never mind or not picked up on it, because I actually do not know what it means. Credence. And as usual, definitions will be stuck into the description. I bear no enmity toward men. Armroad is my native country. I have no wish to harm its people. Thus, I cannot turn a blind eye to the deep one which has seized control of an innocent human. I am currently considering how best to save the people of Armroad from the deep ones. Once you have rested, I will call on you to be the ones to see this plan to fruition. A new mission's available. Well, we're going to take this anyway. Once again, the missions in the middle of the 15th to 16th floor do not matter. You have to take them anyway. Rightful reward for your work, and he gives you 8 grand, which isn't a lot. Then he gives you a lot of EXP, which is a lot. So let's go ahead and distribute skill points, which are now bound and everywhere. You need more Senpuku. You need more. What are you working on? Working on a lot, aren't you? You're always working on something. You need to work on attack order. Regal Radiance, it's fine. Zara didn't level. She's the only one who didn't level. Mina is still working on getting that final level to get Bushin, so get that out there. Yay! The next levels are going to be focusing entirely on Pincushion, and that's going to be fun. Vincent, max alertness, and get to work on, I've been straining away from the strange seeds, rotten eggs, and stuff, but I'm about to leap right back into them. Main reason is because Vincent doesn't have anything left in the wildling side to get, so he may as well start working on his normal skills. I would get more TP up for him so we could use his wildling debuffs more often, but for now, I'm gonna make sure he gets the binding and the I just need the one that binds, which is string seeds. Rotten Egg is not as necessary. Status, lower enemy strength. Yeah, that, I don't want that. Rotten Eggs is not what I'm going for. I'm going for Strange Seeds. That's what I'm going to do there. I'm probably going to cut out a little bit of that stalling. No, now I haven't even accepted the mission. But first, let's go to the Nepir's branch and sell stuff. Toxic Leather, that's from the Manticore. Gives us Slash Mail. Statue Finger comes from the Golem, it's gonna give us Adamo Armor. Rending Fin came from the Crotranga, that's gonna, or whatever his name was, gives us the Randall Dagger. And then we just sell her our usual stuff. Ebony Shards give us a Wing Spear, that's nice. Caster's Eye gives us a Sage Book and the Wisdom Earring. Triad, Gold Carnacle, Skin, Ebon Nail, Hibiscus. Gives us the Kaijin Mistletoe. Oh, that's from the Mistletoes. Kaijin Dial, Hold Rocks gives nothing yet. Okay. Wing Spear is better than, quite a lot better than the Depositoli. So, yeah, you can have it. I'll forge it in a little bit. Don't need that. Don't need that. Don't need that. Still nothing better than the Jolly Roger. How much worse from the Jolly Roger is this? 335 down to 323. That is barely weaker than the Jolly Roger. Barely weaker than the Jolly Roger. That's just insane. And I don't think we got anything else new for you. Yeah, the Harvest Scythe is still your best friend. No. Armor. Slashed Mail. Gives a lot of defense and gives slash resistance. Anyone want to volunteer? Yeah, Vincent does. Vincent, you can have slash mail. Either of you could take advantage of the Adamant armor, so Gandra, you take care of the Adamant armor. And now deal with armor. I do not need the Spiral Belt. And I do not need this energy bracelet. Purple leggings, star bandana, corsesh, pikeman armor, hide armor, tourney, mail, stunning knife stays, spade, go away, and poor Tipos Tilly. I'm gonna go for stuff now, so let's do that. Ebony shards, okay, good. What else? What do you need? What do you need? Couldn't really think of anything good to put on it. Okay, that's fine. And you need blind. Or sleep. You know what? Here, have headbind. Just gonna apply two headbind to it. That's fine. We've already spent a good few minutes just doing that, so that's gonna get cut. That's just gonna be great. Okay, it's just gonna be cut sentry. Now let's go back to Celestial Palace and get this done. Locate the teleporter. And this is essentially the fourth stratum boss quest. At least the Porcelain Forest. I want you to find it so we can protect the city of Armroad. The time has come for me to explain the plan to subjugate. Guessing that's what I think it means, which is to apply to your subjects. The Deep Ones? You are aware that the Deep One is an Armroad as well, are you not? Yes, the Deexidral told us. Some believe that this imposter is truly human, making it difficult to slay as a result. Worse, the imposter is high rank in Armroad and holds great sway there. I have given it some thought, and I think it's best to strike in small numbers at an isolated location. For that, we will require a device allowing us to teleport. It is very like the submagnetic pole. When I was Armroad's master, these devices were commonplace. One such device rests deep within the Abyssal Shrine, providing a direct path to the Royal Forest. I would like for you to find this particular device, so that we may enact the first stage of the plan. If you succeed, we may infiltrate in secret and slay the lurking Deep One, thereby restoring peace. The future of mankind and the harmony of the world all rests on your actions. Now go forth. And that's the story, so let's finally get out of Plot Town, go back to the Abyssal Shrine. I'm going to see you guys back in the Abengazi room. Alright, back in the Abengazi powder room, I ran into a new set that contains all the familiar enemies. We have the usual suspect of disaster, the big snake head, along with the eerie statue. It's great. I love it to death, don't you? So, everyone gang up on the big snake head. And we'll just let Mina and Zera take care of the eerie statue. Don't think anyone else needs to work on it, so we'll just keep it at that. And just let them fight it out. Statue, they both attack Domina, they both miss, that's fine. It's totally allowed. Let's just do this again, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again. Okay, there. Fury Statue died. And we're gonna just start beating up on the big snake head. He's not doing much. Which isn't surprising, but I'm really still not doing a lot of damage to him, which is bugging me. Bugging me to no end that I still can't clear-cut defeat him in like a few turns unless I really try. But regardless, let's go on. Let's move on through here, and we got another Freed Savage that's already on our case. There's probably shortcuts abound, but as I said, as we walk alongside the walls, which we've already been nearby, is when I'm going to check for shortcuts, because that's the easiest time to check for shortcuts. We got treasure. Must avoid temptation? Question mark? I really want that treasure, but I want to get this FWE off my case first, so I can get it safely. So, go down this way. He should be off our case any second now. From what I remember, he should be off our case any second now. I'm reading myself. Being redundant. Is that a dead end? Okay, he's off our case. Is this a dead end? We gotta check. Are you a dead end? Small crevices visible. Not passable from this side. Great. Oh, another one? Well, okay, we got two shortcuts. And that one's I just found on accident. I was just turning around. Alright, let's go get the treasure. Shouldn't take too long. Savage is up there at the end of that corridor. Should not be after our guts right now. So, that gives us a coupon. Well, neato! One of the 6 coupons in the game. I'll be sure to put it to good use, and by that I mean probably never use it. Just like everyone else. It's just I've already said this about the coupon, but I really like how people would sometimes just never even use the coupon. So far I've only used one coupon to get a Jolly Roger for Gandra, back when it was first available. So that's the only time I've used it so far. So everyone just getting up on that, and everyone just getting up on the Eerie statue. It's annoying me. I don't like it in its red eyes. Get rid of it. I command it that it be done. That's not going to take too much longer to kill. Focus your attacks over there. Is everyone have the limits? Yes, okay, good. I just want to make sure that. Instant kill, fire, and we get its normal item for once, which is Broken Rock. Yep, that's its normal item, and we're back to Pit Central. Yay! You didn't think we were done with the pits back there. That was only the introduction. Okay, so we have more pit puzzles and pit rooms and places where the pits will lead us. And it's you kind of have to keep in mind where these pits are going. Like, here's some stairs down. I believe this is supposed to be like... Oh, this puzzle, it's weird. So as I said, I might be cutting as I go through the S-bend curves. So don't mind me. Let's go down here, see what there is to see. Okay, this is just another one of the. This is just another set of long passageways after long passageways. I'm gonna check for shortcuts, and I'll cut if there isn't anything here. I've got something at the end of the hall. Small crevice, basketball. Alright, awesome, we'll keep it in mind. Alright, anything else? Alright, we've run into Deep Marine Central plus Curse Knight. Not too surprising. We'll just use an electric charge Typhoon Bolt combo and get out of here. Won't take that long. Typhoon Bolt, electric charge. It shouldn't take that long, otherwise keep the focus on the Curse Knight. Also, the Curse Knight is immune to instant death effects. From what if I remember anything correctly, is that I can never instant kill this thing, so I think it has a resistance to instant death. That's a lot of damage. That is a lot of damage, and a lot of damage just went everywhere. More spearhead chips. Okay, I didn't find any other shortcuts there, but we'll just remember on every fast visit that if anything else is there, we'll be sure to visit it. Let's go into the second column, which is up here, and see what this has to show us. Got a magic shard. Interesting. Magic shard comes from the Cursed Knights, so it's rare. And there's no shortcuts on this one. So let's go upstairs, and this will take us on the other end of that pit. Very close by. Not too difficult. This might just not be a very easy puzzle that I'm just kind of taking my time on, which is fine. And we got more stairs leading more places, and treasure! About time. Let's go check out what this treasure is. And we get formaldehyde! Yay! I mean, it's there, so we just go up these stairs. And that'll get us on the other side of that pit, which is essentially taking us back where we started, so nothing too much accomplished there. Lots of stairs everywhere. Wait for him. Oh great, we're going down around Espiny Town, so I might not even get to hear what I'm saying. Hey, meets Free Savage! He's a jerk, and I don't like him very much. And I really should be watching where I'm going, which I wasn't for some reason. He has a few attacks. I don't like him very much, but you know what? Fine, we'll try. We'll try. This is gonna suck, but we're gonna try. Start testing for weaknesses. You use regrowth tactic and attack, and you lower its offense before it kills us all. So that should help with the health regeneration. Got attack out. Tweak to fire, that's nice. Got the Beast War out, that's good. Beast, okay, we got the Protect Order out in the front row. You need to get the Protect Order in the back row. Apparently he's, since he's so subtle to fire, that's going to be my easiest way to beat him. So, get that out of the charge out, you attack, and you use Primal Drum's lower defense. Let's see what, gonna see where this gets us. Because if this team of all teams can beat the FOE up, then we're in good shape. We just are. Lower his defense. Alright, the Protect Orders are up. You give Mina fire in case he lives after this. You attack, you attack, you attack. See what that gets us. He hasn't used his Earthquake attack yet. He has Fight Off, which is just a strong attack against one person, and he's down. Okay, awesome. Got Kirk Horn. He's an extremely easy FOE, so I'm kind of okay with killing him. Because at least this time I can't it's not a sequence break, really. It's just me going a different way. Zara, what are you working on? Okay. I didn't think this team could take care of the Freed Savages, but now that I remember it, I'm a little overleveled, and the Freed Savages are painfully easy. So, you know what? No complaints. Freed Savage is dead. I'm thinking he spawned right there and noticed me when I got, like, within three range. And it doesn't look like it was too hard to get here in the first place. Just a little bit of, you just had to go through this stairway over here and just climb up here. So, regardless, you would get here pretty easily. There's no events here. So, it's just basic stuff, and it's just a little confusing, but otherwise, it's not that bad. And we got a mirror image of... This is a mirror image of what happened over there. Except the pits are in a different place. Which is interesting, because we almost had a mirror image. Almost. So let's get this out, and I'm guessing another mural is around the corner over here. Let's check that out. See if we can find it. Going down this way. Want to try to get the rest of this episode done in this one. But if I have to, I'll make a split into a 0.1, 0.2 episode, since it's all one session, just two episodes long. At least to an extent, they're gonna wreck this. Greater attacks, kill the Mina clone, that's fine. And just how weak are you? Alright, defend, defend, attack. This is gonna take a little bit, since he's kinda weak too. Hopefully that won't kill. It killed. Ah, I take too many risks. Oh well. I'm gonna continuously try to get that FOE's item, but until it happens. Okay, this weaves this way, and we're finally taking advantage of the one column. Big snakehead, and meet the new enemy. This isn't the enemy I was referring to, but here's a new enemy, the Epuraria. Big Snakehead's still a jerk, and Imperia is just new. It's not that much difference. I think the Imperia is also weak to the elements, like it's... Oh, this is swashbuckling. Never mind. And now we just have to deal with Big Snakehead. Oddly enough, it didn't hurt Gander that bad. Which is confusing, but I'll go with it. Oh, I headbound it! It's doing less magical damage. If you can somehow cast a magical attack when your heads are bound, you do very, very little damage. So that's why he was doing such a forgettable number for damage. Where am I? Is this... No, this is only the 15th floor, so I'm not sequence breaking, so let's see what's behind this door. This is the way... Yeah, this is the way of progress. I wanted to know where the mural is, so I'm gonna go north and see if that's the way towards the mural. See you guys in 10 seconds. Yep. Keep bashing it. He's still not down, and though I know the moment I choose Vincent to attack, he's gonna die, so come on. Okay, there, and... No success. 80% chance, 85% chance and no success. That's great. I love it when my 85% chance doesn't work. That's just great. Well, I think up here is the Merle. Yay, Merle! I was wondering where you were. As you walk briskly through the Undersea Temple, blah blah blah, Merle. Equilateral triangle. Densely packed forest. So we got a Merle of a densely packed forest. Yes, there we go. Damicus's Edge. And it only took a few few hits from Zera to get him to drop it, so at least I have one. I might need more than the one for the special item of his, but just know you have to beat him with the slam attack. Some people are a little confused, so I'm going to clear this up now. There are three different physical elements, and they each have their own official name, but I just call them the three S's, slash, stab, and slam, which is basically exactly what they look like when I'm attacking with them, so. Hey, this set's really popular. Didn't take that long, but it didn't give me anything. So we got a nice 3x3 room with nothing in it. Okay, there can't be any shortcuts on the bottom, so let's just check the top. Nope. And we got a door! We're barely still in mid-game. After this stratum is basically when late-game begins. And then it's after you beat late-game, it's post-game, so. You know, you should know your typical terminology for how games end, so why am I telling you this? Where's the shortcut? Where's that convenient shortcut? No, oh, it's over there nearby the camp spot. Okay. How do I know there's a camp spot in the next room? Because I'm awfully close to running out of TP, and that just totally signifies that there's a camp spot nearby. It just does. I thought you guys knew that. So I may as well make good use of my skills while I'm still using them. This element. There we go. Oh, right. We've already seen this before. Why am I showing it to you? Because I'm awesome. Duh. Duh. That's obviously how it works, right? Right? Do I get a cookie? Alright, in here is a camp spot, because I'm a total nerd and I know there's a camp spot in here, and it's probably a 3x3 room. Yep, 3x3 camp spot room. And how did I know? I just remembered it. Really, as I said, the floors before this are the least memorable floors in the game. This is probably one of the most memorable floors in the game, that's how I know much more about it. So I'm going to start lending into the term nerd map again. You know that term I used all the way back in episode 2? Yeah, me neither. Rewatching those old episodes kind of makes you cringe. It also makes me cringe, but for the most part, I really wanted to get past the boring beginning part and try to make it as entertaining as possible, which is what I did, and many people think I did a good job, so I'm gonna give myself 2 thumbs up in that department. And then I went Mr. Informative, and some people were like, wait, who are we watching again? It's like, yeah. You're still watching me. Oh, we are about to run into Gates again. Wonderful. I'm gonna quickly pause and go back all the way over here and see what's over up here in E1, BRB. Well, I think this has gone long enough, so I'll see you guys next time for part 66.2. I have no idea what episode number we're on, so just see you next time in point 2. Be right back. See you in a second. Bye.